Yes. Where are you? You up there? There you go. Hail Boreas, Queen Aurora, Community Festival Royalty, honored guests, my dear fellow senior royalty alumni, welcome everyone. We are honored that you have come here today to help us celebrate our super 60th anniversary of the Senior Royalty Program. It's a big deal for us. You know, it may happen to any one of us, but more so to seniors. Your memory bank might begin to change what it yields. And you might even lose the key to your short-term memory. But seniors, our long-term memory seems to remain safe and intact. In fact, it often gathers interest over the years. So it is sort of no really wonder that we have chosen memory as our theme. During the entrance into the room, you may not have heard it, but we were playing the beautiful music from Cat's Memory. In just a few moments, please allow me to sort of refresh our collective memory. They say that one of the last things you forget is your name, so I better tell you who I am. I am Peggy Ann Fang, and it is my honor as president of the Senior Royalty Alumni Association to speak on behalf of all its members who I know, work tirelessly to support the Senior Royalty Program. It is with heartfelt gratitude that we take this opportunity today to recall and to respectfully acknowledge that if it were not for the Department of St. Paul Parks and Recreation, we would not be here today. Because of their dedicated leadership and staff, the Senior Royalty Program was born in 1958, 60 years ago. They nurtured and groomed the program for many years. Then, in 2014, the Senior Royalty Program became of age, so to speak. At that time, the Senior Royalty Alumni Association knew they needed to focus on the future of the program, and we forged a relationship with the St. Paul Festival and Heritage Foundation. And that resulted in a landmark decision of historic proportions for all the senior citizens of the Northlands. Because at that point and henceforth, the legend of King Boreas now includes King Winter, Queen of the Northlands and their court. And therefore, King Boreas, today we promise that we, your loyal subjects, will always try to bring our best of wisdom and goodwill to the citizens of your royal realm. As a simple gesture of our appreciation, I would like it known that Kathy Corum is here today with us, representing Parks and Rec. Kathy, would you stand wherever you are? There she is. She was also very instrumental in a surprise that you will see when the curtains open. Finally, let me recall for you, by the way, is there anyone here from St. Paul Festival and Heritage? I knew that Kathy was here. Okay. So finally, let me recall for you some of the locations for previous ceremonies that we've had. One of the programs that I found going through historical papers was a program dated back to 1976. And at that time, that coronation was held in the St. Paul Civic Center Auditorium. And I believe it's now called the Roy Wilkins Auditorium. We've also held our ceremonies at Washington Junior High, Central High School, many times at St. Catherine's College, at the Landmark, the Sheila and Paul Wellstone Community Center Center for Community Building. And here we are at St. Paul College for the third time. We held our ceremonies here in 2016, 2017, and now here today. I'm wondering if the president of our college is here. No? We were hoping he would be one of our honored guests. He has been very, very supportive of all of us, and we certainly want to thank him. This college community, if you look up its history, is incredible what they bring to our community and to our young adults. In fact, you and I could come to school here if we still so wanted to. But it is a gem in our community, and Rasul has been the president for a number of years now and is doing a fabulous job. And I cannot personally wish him the best, but I so do, for blessings on him and the future of the college. The MC for our ceremony is a very stately gentleman who entered into the life and the spirit of Carnival back in 1970 as a member of the King's Guard. In 1977, captain, and in 1979 and 80, commander of the King's Guard. For his volunteerism, he was presented with the Sal Libido Award in 2008. He has been our MC a number of times, and we are especially grateful that he has agreed to do so on this, our super anniversary. Please welcome our friend, David Larson.
Thank you, Peggy, for those kind words, and thank each and one of you for attending this grand celebration today. We hope you enjoy the presentation and welcome you here today. We were hopeful that Mayor Melvin Carter would be able to accept our invitation to join us today, not just because he is the new mayor of St. Paul, but also because he once reigned as the junior royalty king. However, in a thank you note, he expressed his best wishes for a successful event and hopes that he could connect with us at some point in the future. We have been graced by the presence of visiting royalty and other dignitaries. And as I look in the audience, I do see the Minneapolis Aquitennial Senior Royalty. And if there are any other groups that I have overlooked, please stand. But at this time, I'm going to do something a little out of tradition. I'm going to hand the microphone over to the Aquitennial so they can introduce themselves.
I'm Senior Vice Commodore of the Minneapolis Aquitennial.
I'm Jerry Schultz, the princess for the Aquatennial.
My name is Jim Dane, and I am the senior commodore for the Minneapolis Aquatennial.
Hi, I'm Susan Klug, and I'm the senior queen.
Thank you, Minneapolis Aquatennial Senior Royalty, and we're sure glad to see you because I think you brought some of your weather with us today. I want to briefly take you back to celebration 60 years ago and let you briefly think about what happened in 1958. The first Pizza Hut and International House of Pancake restaurants were open. That's 60 years ago. Elvis Presley was inducted into the Army. And for those of us who have been back in that era, we might remember some of these events. Rickie Nelson had the number one hit on Billboard magazine with the song, Poor Little Fool. The TV programs Peter Gunn, The Rifleman, and 77 Sunset Strip began 60 years ago. The Academy Awards for the Best Picture was Bridge on the River Kwai. And back in 1958, the average income was $4,650, if you can believe that. A new car cost $2,155. Gasoline was 24 cents a gallon, and a postage stamp was only 4 cents. Wow, have times changed. 60 years ago brought back many memories and was a grand year to begin the Senior Royalty Program. No doubt the Senior Royalty Court members of 2017, with the theme Keen in 17, are probably experiencing the same bittersweet feelings that come over all Royal Court members at the end of their reign, feeling sad that it is over and at the same time happy and proud of their exciting and rewarding year. Watch and listen as they say hello and goodbye. Thanks for the memories.
Dark sacred nights, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the skies, also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies crying. I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Both Senior Royalty Alumni Association and guests, what an honor and a privilege to have served as the 2017 Queen of the Senior Royalty of the St. Paul Winter Carnival. I can think of a quote from Maya Angelou, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Words alone could never express the wonderful experiences of the travel to the communities throughout the state, the many friendships I have made with people young and old, and the royalty. Riding on our float and convertibles was an experience to remember. The children waving, calling you by name is a heartwarming memory. Visiting the nursing homes and some businesses and knighting many people and friends and family members was a special highlight. A special thanks to the Queen of the Snows and her royal family. I love you all. A thank you to the Senior Royalty Alumni Association and all who played a part in making my year a success. A very special thanks to Jackie, our coordinator, for her endless work. She's the greatest. A special thanks to my royal family, King Don, Prime Minister Dan, and Our Lady-in-Waiting, Cindy. You have been a lot of fun, and I will cherish this family forever. Good luck to the incoming candidates, and here's wishing you a wonderful, joyful year. For the last time, with crown and gown, I am your 2017 Queen of the Northland of the St. Paul Winter Carnival. I love you all, and may God bless each and every one of you.
Wants to be the first to say goodbye.
Everyone, this is Don Weinberger, King Winter the 59th. What an action-packed and fun-filled time this past year has been for me. While this was certainly the busiest year of my life, it was also one of the most rewarding, if not the most rewarding one ever. At the ripe old age of 61, I've grown a bit, changed a bit, and I'm a better person for having been part of the 2017 Senior Court. To our Queen Shirley Callender, you were poised and elegant, and I was always proud to have you by my side. To our lady-in-waiting, Cindy Thrasher, you were my go-to gal, our organizer. I could always count on you to know where we were supposed to be and when we were supposed to be there. To our Prime Minister, Dan Monson, our court got off to a bit of a rough start, and we needed a new Prime Minister. You graciously agreed to a second consecutive year and immediately became the asset the rest of us needed. To the royal family, the Royal Guard, Klondike Kate, the Juniors, and the Vulcans. Thanks for the warmth and acceptance you've shown the seniors. Anytime we were with any of you, it was really a good day. I really enjoyed the parades and all the smiling faces. It was fun to shout out to other seniors, "Seniors rock!" and watch their faces light up, give us thumbs up, and shout back, "Yes, they do." However, it was the kids that really made an impression on me, especially the Vulcan and Royal Family kids. In many ways, they reminded me of my own grandchildren. I was blown away by the friendliness and hospitality of so many alumni, friends, and current court members of Winter Carnival, who so graciously opened their garages, homes, backyards, and even businesses to host pre-parade or post-parade parties. A big thank you to all the volunteers who helped us behind the scenes and pulled our float. A special thanks to Marilyn DiMartino for her expertise in decorating our float for Halloween, and Dan Leach, who made himself hoarse by working the crowds equally hard for both the juniors and seniors during each parade he was at. Oops, apparently someone slipped through the background check. And Jackie Whitner, could you please explain one thing to me? What the heck is mingling, and how is it done? This is King Winter the 59th, bidding all of you a fond farewell. This was a blast.
Wants to be the first to say goodbye.
Hi, I'm Dan Monson, and I'm the St. Paul Winter Carnival Senior Royalty Prime Minister for 2016 and 2017. And I want to say thank you to everybody. 2016, I had a great time. 2017, I had a greater time. And hopefully in 2018, I have even a better time. But I want to thank the people this year that helped so much. I want to thank Jackie and Colleen and Peggy and all the board members. I want to thank my King Don, Queen Shirley, and Lady-in-Waiting, Cindy Thrasher. We had a ball this year, and it was just a bunch of fun. And that's all I got to say. Love you all. Bye.
Coming to a close. And wow, what a year it has been. Where do I start? Jackie, as seniors, you gave us every opportunity to attend every parade, fundraiser, dinner, and event. You made sure we had a fantastic time of it all. To my court, Shirley, tonight our road trip has finally come to an end, and you now know St. Paul. Dan, your jokes were so funny, I almost forgot to laugh. Every time we rode in Jackie's car, before we even started out, you would reply, "Are we there yet?" And I have a new nickname for you, Candyman Dan. Don, every parade we participated in, you were like a little kid in a candy store. You had so much fun seeing the smiles on the little kids' faces along the parade route. And thanks a lot for carrying the Queen's bag for me. I had a blast hanging out with each and every one of you all year. A special shout out to the royal family, junior royalty, royal guards, Klondike Kate, and the Vulcan's crew. You guys were the cat's meow. To Frank, Marilyn, and Kia, thank you for making our Anoka parade memorable. Yabba dabba doo, meet the Flintstones. Thank you.
Hail the 2017 Senior Royal Court. Please stand and applaud and thank them for their successful reign. Thank you for a wonderful year. Now that they have completed their year on a royal court, both Shirley and Don are now official members of the Senior Royalty Alumni Association. Dan and Cindy were already members, having served on previous courts. Again, congratulations. Even though the Senior Royalty Alumni Association membership increases every year, sadly, it often suffers the loss of some of its members. Gwendolyn Jefferson, the Senior Royalty Alumni Association chaplain, will now lead us in a prayerful pause in memory of SRAA members who died in 2017.
Today, as the Winter Carnival Senior Royalty Alumni Association celebrates its 60 years of royal festivities, it is only prudent that we remember the words of the Psalm 86, verse 10, "For thou art great and doest wondrous things. Thou art God alone. And then in verse 11, we read, "Teach me thy way, O Lord. I will walk in thy truth. Unite my heart to fear thy name." And indeed, these beautiful souls we memorialize this afternoon showed us this with their strength, their wisdom, and their goodwill that only comes from trusting in the Lord. And so as we call out our alumni that have crossed over, if indeed you were part of that court, stand in solidarity of our memorial. First, we remember Dorothy Drake. Dorothy was the 2005 Princess of the Four Winds. We remember Celeste Gagliardi, 2010 Lady in Waiting. Dorothy Heinlein, 1988 Lady in Waiting. Einar Nordstrom, 1994 Prime Minister and 1997 King Winter 39. They are resting in peace.
Thank you, Gwendolyn, for remembering our friends. Mary Livingston has been a friend and supporter of the Senior Royalty Program for many, many years. Even after working for Parks and Recreation for 35 years, she still continues to be active in the senior community, directing the senior singing groups, the Golden Melody Makers, and helping individuals heal with their skill in therapeutic musician. Today, Mary has chosen a piano selection for us that was written in 1915. It's a song from the Tin Pan Alley days called Memories. Mary, we're so happy St. Paul College had a grand piano, and for that, our entertainment, you made it really sound grand. Thank you, our mistress of music, Mary Livingston. At this time, the president of St. Paul College has arrived, so we'd ask Dr. Wasul if you'd come forward, please, and say a few words.
Good afternoon, everybody. My apologies for going to Minneapolis on a Friday afternoon and coming back, and Super Bowl is not even here yet, and we have to endure the traffic. So on behalf of our 11,500 students, whom 64% are diverse, and 450 faculty and staff, I want to give you a warm welcome, and this is not a metaphor, truly a warm welcome. Look at the temperature outside. People in the Red Bull crushed ice are very nervous, but to St. Paul College. We've been a college since 1910, and your organization has had a legacy of celebrating Winter Carnival since 1886. If you walk around and saw the college, we're growing like mushrooms and steroids. We just added a $20 million health sciences Alliance Center that would add another 350 students to our capacity. We have 53 programs, technical programs, and I believe some of your king and queens actually graduates of St. Paul College, alum of St. Paul College. And we graduated 1,500 students last year. Our economic impact is about $256 million a year in our community. And we are creating opportunities for the future of Minnesota, the very diverse future of Minnesota. So I want to welcome you on behalf of our staff and faculty on this warm and beautiful day to St. Paul College. It could have been about minus 40, but it is plus 43. And I hope you have fun. It's almost like homecoming for me because every year I've witnessed that in the last 4 years at least you've been here. This is your home. This is your house. Our college is your college. So thank you very much for blessing us with your presence. And I hope you enjoy yourself. And if you want to see the actions of the crushed ice tonight, go on the fourth floor commons. You don't have to go outside, but you could see all the people kind of rolling down, and hopefully they won't fall by the wayside and hurt themselves. So thank you very much for being here and enjoy your time. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wasul, and thank you very much for letting us have our coronation in your fine auditorium here. As always, King Winter has continued the time-honored tradition of sending loyal alumni in search of worthy successors to his court. However, before introducing the 2018 candidates, please allow me to introduce the distinguished panel of judges. Jerry Schultz, 2014 Queen of the Northland and 2017 Senior Aquitennial Princess. Megan Quiggle, 1994 Princess of the West Wind and past Princess Association President. Marilyn Taylor, 2015 Lady in Waiting. Anita Mack, 2013 Klondike Kate. Crystal Ibu Obana, 2015 Queen of Snows. Marilyn Anderson, Queen of the Northland 2011, hostess for the information meeting and interviews. And chief judge this year is Dorothy Franzen, 2009 Lady in Waiting. The selection process of our new monarchs is a very important role. It is not an easy task to select the candidate who is best qualified to be prince, prime minister, lady-in-waiting, queen, or king. On behalf of the senior royalty alumni officers and members, thank you, judges, for your service. Each candidate wrote a short bio, which I will read in alphabetical order. Please come to the stage with your escort. Christina Sarah Cedes. Escorted by her son, Stephen Sarah Cedes. Christina is a Minnesota transplant from Southern California. She worked for 3M Company for 36 years and has been married to Gerald for 35 years. Together, they have four grown children, one daughter-in-law and two granddaughters. Her husband and two sons were with the 34th Infantry Division Red Bulls and veterans in both Iraq and Afghanistan. While growing up in Hollywood, California, her next-door neighbor was Fred Mertz from the I Love Lucy show. Her second language is Spanish. Thank you. Judy Holmquist, escorted by her son, Tony Carlson. Judy now enjoys semi-retirement. She is an active volunteer with the Minneapolis Senior Aquatennial. She is a member of the St. Paul Festival and Heritage Foundation, as well as the St. Paul Winter Carnival Ambassadors Group. She says the Aquatennial brings sunshine and warmth, while the Winter Carnival brings the magic of winter coolness and snowflake kisses. Judy states that she loves her festival family and friends and the wonderful feeling it brings to volunteer to make each festival the best it can be. Judy Holmquist. Linda Jones, escorted by her brother Mark Vogel. And we do on occasion let people that were Vulcans or Red in here once in a while, but you must have snuck in here. Linda is a 20-plus year resident of Burnsville. She has three adult children and three grandchildren. She works for the state of Minnesota and really enjoys her duties of purchaser and seminar planner. One of her favorite community activities is being a board member for the Burnsville Fire Muster and Community Celebration, where she helps to put on a four-day community festival and holds the title of vendor chairperson. She loves going to craft fairs and food truck festivals. She also loves spending time with family and playing bingo with friends. She looks forward to all the activities of the St. Paul Winter Carnival. Dan Munson, escorted by his daughter, Lori Schultz. And Lydia. Okay. Dan is a fun-loving person. He considers himself a St. Paul boy. His love of tropical fish and birds led him to work in the pet industry. His friends call him Fishman Dan. But he likes to be called Dad, and now Grandpa is the best. He volunteers at the St. Paul Cathedral. Dan spent 4 years in the U.S. Navy on the submarine USS Tang. He is grateful for the care he gets at the VA Medical Center. We also add to his bio the fact that Dan has served as a senior prime minister in 2016 and as an emergency fill-in prime minister in 2017. Thank you. Shirley Malkin, escorted by her son, Brian Hansen. I love my hometown, St. Paul, where I have lived my entire life. The city has made me who I am today, a strong woman with love for God, family, and community. My father first sparked my passion for the Winter Carnival when he took my sister and me to hunt for the medallion and attend carnival events. I would be so honored to be part of the senior royal family in the city that has always made me proud to be a hometown girl. Congratulations, candidates. Thank you for your desire to continue the senior royalty legacy. Relax now and enjoy the rest of the program. At this time, would the Queen of Snow's candidates form your icicle honor guard as we welcome the mighty monarch of snow and ice, King Boreas, Queen Aurora, and their royal family to the throne room. And I would like to especially thank Bert Wolf, who has coordinated for the last 3 years and assisted the candidates here and has helped us so much in the past. Thanks, Bert. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce His Excellency, the Prime Minister to the Royal Court of Boreas Rex and Aurora, the Queen of Snows and the St. Paul Winter Carnival, from the Royal House of St. Croix Hospice, Heath Bartness.
Well, what a pleasure it is to be here today.
I saw the video and I'm really wondering where the wisdom came from. After seeing Don up against the police cars, I'm not quite sure. I'm confident that the wisdom that you were supposed to be bringing us was there, but certainly your entertainment value was spot on. At this time, I'd like to introduce the 2017 St. Paul Winter Carnival Royal Family, beginning with the Captain of the King's Guard from the Royal House of FFP Wealth Management, Captain Chris Cruz. From the Royal House, Amamatis Castle Tap, LCS Companies, Sam Jellybean Moran. The eldest of the King's brothers, hailing from the blustering north, from the Royal House of Hammernix Decorating, North Twin Prince, Eric Patika. And his lovely princess, hailing from the Royal House of Vocal Essence, Johanna Smith. The second eldest of the King's brothers, the mischievous wind from the east, hailing from the Royal House of Donald's Uniform, Brian Laughlin. His brother princess, hailing from the Royal House of Seven Hills Benefit Partners, Ellie Carter. Next, we have that dependable wind from the west, hailing from the Royal House of Quality Refrigeration, West Wind Prince Jory Lexon. And his lovely princess, hailing from the Royal House of River Run Team Remax Results, Molly Ruther. Escorting our Southwind princess down the aisle, the guard from the Royal House of the Bungalow Inn of Lakeland and Guardian Pest Solutions, Romeo Perez. And his sassy Southwind princess from the Royal House of the Rice Street Festival, Elena Hammond.
Olé! 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 Ooh-la-la!
Joining us this evening, we have two mistresses of song and merriment. First, Klondike Kate 2017 from the Royal House of Dunham's West St. Paul, Kristen Oster. And the Super Bowl Kate from the Royal House of Aesop's Table, 2018 Klondike Kate, Natalia Hemingway.
And now, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the king, the true king of the St. Paul Winter Carnival, from the Royal House of Bradshaw, celebration of life, Boreas Rex the 81st, Jason Bradshaw!
Well, thank you, everyone. It is a great pleasure to be here with you this evening, and especially to celebrate the wonderful year that our seniors had. It has been such an honor to serve with them, and one of the things our family has talked about since day one is Carnival being a place to bring all people together, and that's people with all backgrounds, races, beliefs, and ages. And this is a place that can bring people together. And so it has been so fun to celebrate this year with the juniors and the seniors. And it's just pulling everybody together. It has been absolutely awesome. So the seniors have been so distinguished and have represented you so well. And they I will say, I don't know if any group has had more fun than the seniors. They are an absolute riot. I will also say that there's a little level of mischievousness also with them, I think, too. I remember being at one parade, and my little daughter, Marta, came walking up, and she had a piece of candy. And I said, Marta, where did you get the candy? And she points over, and there's the seniors float, and all four of them are waving. It's like the seniors. And then also the time that my pillow disappeared, and it came back all blinged out. And I knew at that point, the seniors. Anyway, they were absolutely wonderful, and it has been such an honor to celebrate and enjoy this year with you. We will dearly miss all of you, and it has been, again, just a great pleasure getting to know you. So thank you so much. At this time, I would like to introduce our very gracious Aurora Queen of the Snows, Lindsay Sandoval, from the Royal House of Amber Graves, Coldwell Banker Burnett.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are so excited to be here, and I'm short, so I'm going to come around this way. I just have to say thank you so much for a great year, and to Dan, too. It's been so fun to watch you all this year have so much fun, and we got to ride in the car together. And I can just think of moments that we've shared together, precious memories that we've had and conversations that we've had. And I just want to say that you all have made an impact this year, not just on other people, but on us as well. So thank you very much.
Now, I know we are on a time schedule, but having two mistresses of song and merriment both here, I feel like we have to ask for a song. Would you ladies be so kind? Okay.
Anything for you, King Gloria.
You're learning quick.
It's Winter Carnival, come on, get happy. The time to celebrate is now. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. The gates are here to show you how. The Vulcan crew is getting ready to start melting the snow away. King Boreas and his family will do their best to make it stay. We're headed for good times, so won't you come along? The fun and the frolic will last from dusk till dawn. It's Winter Carnival, come on, get happy. The time to celebrate is now. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. The cates are here to show you how.
I said the cates
are here to show you how.
Hail the cates and hail the seniors. Wow, what an incredible year. I can't tell you truly again how magical it has been to get to know you seniors, and to echo the words of Boreas, boy, they have had a lot of fun. Royal Guards, Royal Family, I think we should give a curtsy to our seniors before we exit the stage. Royals! Captain, please assemble the family.
Thank you.
happening here now?
Ladies and gentlemen, we are the show. We represent the heat. And think about when you walk outside today, we brought that warmth. They're not quite doing their job right now, are they? Now, I do want to say that we have the Vulcans here. We have Evie, Sparky, Ash, Flame, and we have Vulcanus. And I do want to say that it's a pleasure to come and visit the seniors here. I will say personally, I happen to be sooty, and I represent the oldest individual in the Vulcan group. And what I'd like to say is, every time we come to a parade, there's certain people that you search out. And we enjoy the royal family, but one of the individuals that we really do enjoy is the senior royalty. They bring the life, they bring enjoyment, and they have enthusiasm beyond anybody in any age. Thank you very much. By the way, we do have an appointment right now, so we have to head out. But thank you very much.
Thank you, Boreas, Aurora, and your royal family and Vulcans for adding that festive attitude that we need here and we receive every year when you come. Order in the throne room. Please, everyone, return to your seats. The clock is ticking. It's time for more pageantry. The coronation of the 2018 Senior Royal Court of the St. Paul Winter Carnival. Tom Smith, our Lord High Chamberlain in recent years, is not able to be with us tonight. So Boreas and Aurora, we have asked to borrow your Prime Minister to assume the role of Lord High Chamberlain. Please welcome again Sir Heath Bartness.
I can't tell you how much this is a highlight of my year. I wish my wife were here to know that I am Lord High Chamberlain this evening. We have had an absolute wonderful, wonderful experience being able to spend time with the seniors, as I said earlier. But I'll tell you what, I'm looking very much forward to 2018 and spending time with you seniors right here.
The results of the royal judges are in securely locked in this chest you see on my left. Judge Dorothy Franzen, would you please bring the key to the Lord Chamberlain? By so doing, you will fulfill your duty and responsibilities as Chief Judge. We once again express our appreciation for the time the judges spent in performing your royal assignment. The air of excitement is rising. Senior royalty candidates, please come forward to center stage. Assisting Jackie Whitner, the senior court coordinator, are our newly crowned junior royalty. Please come forward. We have King Frost, Owen Kelm. Princess of Ice, Angelica Severin. Princess of Snow, Lindsay Belting. Prince of Ice and Snow, Alexander Thule. And Queen of the Snowflakes, Isabella Bowie. Congratulations, we know that you'll make King Boreas proud, and you can be certain that the senior royalty look forward to enjoying your youthful exuberance. Lord Chamberlain, it is time to unlock the chest. Remove the first envelope, break the golden seal, and read its contents. Envelope number one.
Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye, citizens of the Northland. The honorable judges appointed by the Senior Royalty Alumni Board hereby decree King Winter the 60th, Dan Monson, January the 19th day, 2018, signed by the official decree of Lord Chamberlain Heath.
Lord High Chamberlain, who will be in King Winter's Prime Minister? Break the golden seal of the second envelope, please.
Hear ye, citizens of the Northlands. The honorable judges appointed by the Senior Royalty Alumni Board hereby decree Prime Minister Shirley Malkin, January the 19th, signed by the decree of Lord High Chamberlain.
Lord High Chamberlain, please announce the selection of this year's Lady in Waiting, envelope number three, please.
Hear ye, citizens of the Northland. The honorable judges appointed by the Senior Royalty Alumni Board hereby decree Lady in Waiting, Linda Jones.
Thank you.
Lord High Chamberlain, we await your announcement of the Princess of the Four Winds. Envelope number 4, please.
Hear ye, citizens of the Northland. The honorable judges appointed by the Senior Royalty Alumni Board hereby decree Princess of the Four Winds, Judy Mae Holmquist.
Lord High Chamberlain, yes, my guess is she knows. And you know we must formally declare the contents of the fifth envelope.
Hear ye. Citizens of the Northland. The honorable judges appointed by the Senior Royalty Alumni Board hereby decree Queen of the Northlands, Christina Saracides!
At the 2018 Senior Royal Court is at their thrones. Lord High Chamberlain, please declare the official decree.
We here bestow on Dan Monson, King Winter the 60th, Shirley Malkin, Prime Minister, Linda Jones, Lady-in-Waiting, Judy Holmquist, Princess of the Four Winds, Christina Saracides, Queen of the Northland, all rights, responsibilities, dignity, and delights of your reign, beginning this date, January the 19th, 2018. Please stand and congratulate the 2018 Winter Carnival Senior Royalty Court.
Thank you.
Chamberlain, and we'll let your wife know that you did a fine job and should retain that title.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you all for participating in the 60th Senior Royalty Coronation. Enjoy the many events of the St. Paul Winter Carnival because it is the coolest celebration on earth. For those of you who desire to take photos, please allow the official royal photographer to complete his duties before you ascend and take your photos. And now we'll have a few closing remarks by the President of Senior Royalty Alumni Association, Peggy.
Don't they look grand? Again, I want to thank everybody for coming here today. I was so worried that our whole celebration was going to be crashed by the Red Bulls, but boy, I think it's been one of our best, and I'm very proud of everyone who worked so hard to make this happen. And I hope that you enjoy the rest of the evening. The chef here at the college has prepared a wonderful meal for those who have made dinner reservations. So I'm just thrilled for everybody. I don't have enough words. Thank you too to our staff from the college here who helped us, Mr. Fang. I laughed because my name is Ann Fang and he's Fang. So we have we had a laugh over that. But anyway, and to Mary Livingston with the bells, she did a great job. So again, Lou is taking pictures for us for the memory, and I do hope that you take the memory of this delightful day and evening home and cherish it for years to come. God bless you all. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Star Wars?